Today we had the privilege of meeting with Gagik Sardarian, who is the director of CART, the Center for Agro, Business and Rural Development, who is doing innovative, groundbreaking work in agricultural development and development aid in the country.
We, as a CART Foundation, we continue USDA, Department of Agriculture, a long-lasting project in Armenia, which started back in 1992-1993. Mm-hmm. After privatization of land and agriculture, Armenian government asked for technical support. Mm-hmm. US Embassy, USDA reacted. Then in 1996, there was another direction of USDA project in Armenia, which called Marketing Assistance Project. Mm-hmm. At that time I was involved designing the strategy paper for Marketing Assistance Project in Armenia, and I was the only Armenian who was in the design team. It was a USDA-USAID joint design team in Armenia. Then I was offered to come to work for the project. But that time I got a scholarship and I decided to quit everything in Armenia and go.
Where?
Greece. That was International Institute, University. And then I did my another master in after my having PhD and master in agriculture. I decided also in economics and management. I came back then, again I was offered the job, the same
at
USDA MEM. Mm-hmm. Then I completed my master and I said, okay, why not? I would like to join.
And you've been here ever since?
Since the 97, end of the 97, yeah. The first boutique winery was established in 1994 in Armenia. Many people were skeptic that time when invited to the opening. It was a two-room operation, but there was a start. Young people and families, they started with the designing of new wine, new label, new approach in the winery. That winery we finished something like months ago when we helped them to design a some agro-tourist component. U.S. Ambassador was there, John Heffern, governor of the region. That was nice to see that the winery today is producing more than 150,000 bottles of wine, and more than half they ship to Russia. And they every day they have a tourist, and so it was from two-room operation it became very successful. But the more important part of this success story is the spread effect.
Okay.
When people in the region, they from small investments something could be done, some value-added production with a local grape. Then today we have more than 15 small size wineries in that valley. And some of these wineries today, if you visit, you can see this type of wineries in Napa Valley, in France, in Italy. So
can you tell us what different areas that CART is involved in today in agricultural, rural development in the country?
So we are leading in many areas like greenhouse development, livestock, especially goats and cows, yes, wine and cheese production. These are the main sectors we, and dry fruit also, dry fruit. And in all sectors we bring innovation, new technologies.
Because I know that you also have farming service centers in different areas of the country that assist farmers, whether it's in livestock or how to have a better crop in potatoes, I'm assuming, right?
Soon we'll open the third one in June, but end of 2014 we'll have something like six, seven service centers. You should always talk to farmers and people and see where the needs are. Also,
and not tell them what their needs are, yes. Ask them what their needs are. I mean, that's the problem with development aid everywhere,
because
I think, in every sector.
Development aid is coming like this. There's a tender. You should deliver your proposal within 1 or 2 months. Okay, you are not so genius within 1 or 2 months to know what Armenia will
what the
need
needs are.
In 5 years, you know. And deliver detailed plan what should be done. But USDA was different, you know.
They weren't like that.
No, because they're not kind of a classical donor. People are coming from land-grant universities. Mm-hmm. They always were involved with talking to farmers in U.S. Mm-hmm. And they are not kind of teaching farmers, but they're working with farmers as a partners. They listen farmers. And they brought the same approach to USDA MEP in Armenia, and that was transferred to CARD. And we continue the same way.
That same tradition. So today, do you receive funding from USDA?
Yes, we still receive funding from USDA, but it's going...
It's diminishing.
Diminishing, because that's how the CARD was created. USDA, one day, they said, that, okay, we may leave the country, but we don't want to close the doors like other donors and say, okay, we did our work and we are leaving the country. We would like to help local staff to create an organization which will continue similar work.
Which is the best thing, because that's sustainability.
That's a sustainability. CARD Foundation established in 2006, the daughter organization, mm-hmm. CARD Agro Service.
CARD Agro Service.
It's a close joint stock company,
right.
For profit. Within a USDA period of time and CARD, we helped the cheese producers to create more than 25 new cheese varieties.
In Armenia, because today in Armenia, for our viewers, we have excellent blue cheese, what do we call it? Hollandagam banir that we call, and I think we also have different cheeses like Camembert and that are being produced locally in Armenia, and they're really tasty cheeses.
And we have done a lot of interesting things with all of these cheeses you mentioned. We have kind of different stories, how we started, with which partner, how it became a successful project. We have about like something like 25 new cheese varieties. Even today,
your organization assisted.
Yes.
And you didn't just assist them in the technology of how to make those cheeses, but also in marketing them.
In marketing, yes.
Being able to export them.
Yes. Through this project initiated the first export of Armenian cheeses to Moscow, first container.
Which year was that, do you remember?
It was 2001 or 2002. Basically, myself and our colleagues, we just were weighing the boxes, loading.
Yeah,
we have pictures. The first container, because we wanted to be sure that everything is going correctly.
Right.
When the first container arrived, then the importer, he came with a list of complaints that the boxes, when we deliver to supermarket chains, there are differences in the way. In Russia, in supermarkets, they have these scales electronic. In the Tashir region, we had this Soviet big, huge... Then
I think that's so funny. They had electronic and we had the old, you know.
So
it's like
started,
a calculator and an abacus.
We started to come back from the market and change everything here in the production.
So it was really a learning process for you.
Yes.
And your organization,
yes.
As well.
Yes, because we spent in Moscow several months. introducing Armenian cheeses to the supermarket chains, exhibitions in restaurants, doing free tasting and so. But after several years, we were in Moscow in supermarket and we saw Russians, not Armenians, Russians entering the cheese section and asking, do you have a Lori cheese? Lori became a brand name. And this all
done. You helped in the branding? Did you help in the branding of Lori?
Yes. So,
you know, Gagik, I think you should be the next Minister of Agriculture, but we'll discuss that after the show. No, because I'm just thinking, I mean, the amount of work that you're doing today as an organization, and I certainly don't want to get political, I'm just going to ask the question. I mean, do you work with the Ministry of Agriculture today?
Yes, we are very good partners. We work in many areas that we cover, and they provide support. Government started many times to do this subsidized artificial insemination program, but always there was no good results. Well, and we put in the totally in private base. Farmers, they see
far the more efficient, I would say.
Farmers, they see the result. They pay for good semen. Right. Veterinarians, they do insemination, and many veterinarians earn good salaries, good money doing this service to farmers. Something like.
So it's this whole chain that's, you know. That's
and we train veterinarians. So we bring semen from US. Worldwide Series company provides also technical assistance. Twice a year, they have experts coming based on our demand, what we ask for. They train our vets, our farmers, and us local staff. So the chain is working. Through CARD Agro Service, we link Armenian farmers and agrobusinesses with world best agriculture input supplies and equipment and machinery supplies. Usually we work with successful companies in the world, started from the artificial insemination or seeds for greenhouses up to John Deere tractors and combines.
So in reality, what you're doing today is you're bringing in, as you said, some of the best products in the industry that, you know, sitting in Armenia, we might think, oh, who's going to buy a John Deere tractor, right? But when you're assisting the farmer, when you're training the veterinarian, you're bringing in the best products, you're completing the whole agricultural chain, and you're also being self-sufficient as an organization, as a foundation, as a company. I think the work you're doing is really, really, really incredible. But have you been able to be successful, for example, in the John Deere, in the farming machinery side of it as well? So it's so you're helping bring new cheese varieties to Armenia. You're marketing them, you're exporting them, you're packaging them, you're building wine boutique wineries and helping the wine industry in Armenia. You're helping farmers create, produce better livestock.
Because it's related
by doing the artificial insemination.
Yeah, it relates to income. For example, the farms where we successfully implement this artificial insemination program, they reach the level of 3,000-4,000 liters per cow.
As opposed to what?
It's opposed to less than 2,000 national average.
The national average is 2,000 liters per cow.
Yes.
So it's providing service, it's providing technical assistance. I mean, it's just incredible for me. This year...
Also very interesting point here. Kind of first time we are building private extension service. Transferring of knowledge, information and training goes with products.
Way we approach development aid and the way we approach our vision for projects, it's not good enough to build a shiny, beautiful building and hand it over and say, here it is with all the latest technology, when you haven't transferred the knowledge. And that is the key that we keep forgetting. And this is why I think where your success has been, in terms of just the way you approach your projects, but also in the way that you're dealing with the companies that you're working with, representing their products, the best in the world, bringing their technology, experience, and knowledge, and passing it on to our farmers, keeping them on the land. so that, you know, we are not depopulating our country, I think is a phenomenal approach and something that other organizations should take away from. I mean, should learn from you when, in that sense.
Yesterday we were in the Dustermelen dairy cheese producing company in Tashir with US Ambassador John Heffer. Again, when first we visited this company, there was just one room, 500 liters of milk, and three people working, two brothers and wife of one of them. Today is one of the biggest and best cheese producer in Caucasus. In the Caucasus. I'm not talking about Armenia. If you go, you that cheese plant, you may think, oh, some oligarch came here.
Really? But it was just a small family thing.
It is a family business. They grow up from one room operation, 500 liters of milk process.
And today, how many liters of milk?
In the season, it's more than 20,000 liters. In that time, I took the interesting picture yesterday because I saw the women coming with a 10 liter of milk from their buckets. But they got also big tanks are coming from villages. And this company, through USDA and CART support, they got access to Moscow market. They shipped their product to California.
California.
Yes.
For me, the biggest story or the biggest lesson to take away from all of this, and always, is that if you start something you believe in with three people, two brothers and a wife, with 50 liters of milk, and it is possible to be successful in Armenia. It is possible to be successful as a farmer in Armenia. But there's a lot of room for improvement, I'm sure.
Yes.
And you're filling that, your organization is filling that void, I think, that exists today.
It's all about people.
Yes.
It's not that project did everything. No, 95% of the success, it's people.
Yeah. And finding the right people,
yeah,
the right...
right partners.
Right.
We were lucky to have very good partners, but unfortunately, maybe we couldn't cover all the needs in agriculture in Armenia. We have a limited budget, limited resources, but with these examples, with wine, cheese, greenhouse...
which we can find in this magazine, for example.
The biggest obstacle for us, it's... when we go to the villages and we see the doors are closed.
There's nobody left.
The people left the village or country. Then we see that there are no potential to growth and how you can be successful if around the...
You need people.
You need people. If we take, let's say, only equipment sector or greenhouse or milking machines or some, then we see that similar direction in Kazakhstan, in Ukraine, in Russia have bigger offices than our offices, because it's market, you know, it's people.
Right.
So we need people.
We need people. So they can pay for our services and produce enough food, not only for local market, but to export to Russia, to different countries. That's our dream.
I think it's a dream that we all should share and expand upon. I really want to thank you for taking the time to meet with us. I'm sure that our viewers are going to be very impressed and very thrilled to know that there is an organization like this. And, you know, this is a call to action. We need people, we need new values, we need new technology, new knowledge, and that's something that you have started and will be the building block, I hope, to future success of our country too.
Thank you.
Thank you.